Well, good morning everyone. How's life? Great, excellent, yay! It's me, Brodin, and today we are going to discuss about 12 overused words in our daily English. Nah, teman-teman, ketika kita belajar bahasa Inggris, kita seringnya mulai dengan menggunakan vocab-vocab yang basic, right? Sadly, those basic vocabularies masih tetap kebawa seiring berjalannya waktu. Kita sampai sekarang pakai bahasa Inggris untuk professional purpose, like melamar kerja, untuk persiapan beasiswa, and other professional purpose. We still use those obsolete vocabularies, right? Nah, that's why it can make our speech sound boring. And kalau misal kita masih tetap pakai vocab yang basic itu, kita nggak bakal bisa jadi seperti native speaker. That's why here I will give you alternatives and references on how to substitute those overused and obsolete words in our daily English. Nah, selain itu teman-teman, ketika kita bisa mengimprove our vocabulary, kita bisa memberikan lebih banyak warna to our speech and also written English. That's why, let's go to discuss the vocabularies. The first one, we have important. Nah, kita sering bingung kan pasti kalau misal kita mau ngomong bahasa Inggrisnya penting apa ya? Bahasa Inggrisnya penting pasti satu doang yang terpikir di otak kita, yaitu important. Well, that's why important termasuk dalam overused words. Karena kita nggak tahu lagi gimana kalau mau ngomong penting, tapi selain important. Well, here you can say things like significant or essential. Nah, for instance, contohnya seperti, well, the meeting is quite essential for our company. Kayak gitu. Nah, kita jadi nggak perlu pakai important lagi, oke? Okay? The next one, interesting. Nah, ketika kita mau bilang menarik, pasti yang kepikiran cuman interesting doang, right? Nah, maka dari itu, here the references are, you can say intriguing or cool. For the example, well, that's a cool story you have. Next, kita ada kata maybe. Nah, maybe ini guys juga jadi salah satu fillers di bahasa Inggris. As we know, kalau misal kita bingung kadang kita suka nyeplos maybe, maybe, maybe. Nah, kalau misal kita mau ngomong mungkin, kita juga seringnya masih pakai maybe. That's why maybe itu juga salah satu dari overused words. However, we can change maybe into perhaps or probably. Contohnya misal, well, he will probably be here in 2 hours. Okay. Next, ada of course. Nah, of course ini kalau misal kita mau menekankan something in English, kita pasti bilangnya of course. Bro, have you got your dinner? Of course I have. Of course mulu. That's why of course juga jadi salah satu dari overused words, oke? Okay? Nah, for the references, you can say things like undoubtedly and certainly. Oke, okay, contohnya adalah, well, he certainly deserves the award. Kayak gitu. Next, ada about. Nah, about ini maksudnya adalah sekitar. Sekitar yang dalam artian angka. For instance, dia bakal datang sekitar jam 2. Atau harganya sekitar 700 ribu. Nah, ketika kita mau bilang sekitar dalam konteks ini, kita pasti cuma kepikiran about, about, and about. That's why about also one of the overused words in English. Nah, maka dari itu, teman-teman bisa ganti about jadi approximately. Kayak gitu. Contohnya, the meeting will be postponed for approximately 2 hours. Next, kita ada smart. Nah, ketika kita mau ngomong pinter, pasti yang kepikiran cuma satu, yaitu smart. That's why smart mostly is an overused word in English, right? Maka dari itu, the references to say other than smart, itu kita bisa pakai genius or whiz kid. For the example, we know that kid is a mathematical whiz kid. Kayak gitu tuh. Next, we have rich. Nah, yang satu ini juga sering banget dipakai karena kita mostly nggak tahu mau gimana lagi kalau ngomong kaya, right? However, we have things to say. Kita bisa pakai opsi like affluent or wealthy. Contohnya, misal, we know that Bruce Wayne is an affluent man in Gotham City. Okay. Next, we have famous. Right? Kalau misal kita mau ngomong orang itu terkenal, kita pasti mostly pakainya famous, ya kan? That's why famous juga salah satu dari overused word. Well, here are the references. To say other than famous, teman-teman bisa bilang well-known or popular. Contohnya, well, we know Brodin is popular because he is handsome. Okay, next, ada yang namanya and then. Nah guys, and then ini in English juga sering banget dipakai sebagai fillers. Karena kalau misal kita ngomong pasti and then mulu gitu, right? That's why here and then teman-teman bisa ganti dengan moreover, furthermore, atau next. Kayak gitu. For instance, I like to eat fried rice. Furthermore, if the fried rice is spicy. Next, we have I think. Nah, I think kebanyakan teman-teman kalau mulai ngomong kita pasti buka dengan I think. I think, I think. That's why I think is also one of the overused words in English. Well, kita bisa ganti pakai kata-kata yang lebih advance, yaitu I believe that, I suppose, atau in my opinion. Kayak gitu. Okay? For instance, well, I believe that Mr. Bob is one of the best course in Pare. Gitu. Next, kita ada very bad. Nah, kalau kita mau ngomong buruk banget, kita pasti pakainya adalah very bad mulu, ya kan? That's why very bad is also one of the overused words in English. However, teman-teman bisa ganti dengan terrible. Contohnya, I have had a terrible day today. Kayak gitu. And the last one. This is a bonus for all of you. Mungkin kalau teman-teman pengen kelihatan sweet di depan partnernya, di depan doinya, ketika teman-teman bilang I love you so much, tapi teman-teman nggak tahu mau ngomong apa lagi, ya kan? Well, teman-teman ngomongnya I love you so much mulu. Nah, biar kelihatan keren di depan doinya teman-teman, you can say this one. I love you to the moon and back. Kayak gitu, guys. Well, itu tadi adalah 12 vocab yang paling sering kita gunakan in our daily English. Nah, mulai sekarang teman-teman sudah tahu dari advanced version of those vocabularies. Mari kita praktekkan di daily English kita dan semoga kita bisa menjadi seperti native speaker dan jadi lebih keren lagi ketika ngomong bahasa Inggris. Well, that's all for me, Brodin. And the last I say, Mr. Bob, super seru.